Go.
In my first book published in America by Paradigm Press, or Seeds of Peace, it became a bestseller, translated into quite a few languages. And in that book, I made a distinction between capital B Buddhism and small B Buddhism. Small B Buddhism, that you try to bring the best message of the Buddha, that is learning to restructure yourself, to be less selfish in order to serve all sentient beings. And you try to transform greed into generosity, hatred into nonviolence, and delusion into wisdom. That's small B Buddhism. Even a Christian can be Buddhist. Even a non-believer can be Buddhist. Because the Buddha never monopolized that word. Buddha means to awake. But once Buddhism becomes established, it becomes part and parcel of nationalism. In Sri Lanka, the Sinhalese are Buddhist, and they killed the Tamils. Recently, the former president of Sri Lanka killed the Tamils after they put their white flag on. They declared that they were defeated. Yet he killed more than 50,000 Tamils. I was one of the panel condemning him on committing crime against humanity. And yet he claimed to be Buddhist. And many Buddhist monks in Sri Lanka support. Now, in my country, we have a group called the Dhammakaya. They preach the teaching of Buddha contrary to what he taught. He said the more you acquire is better. The more you spend money on them, you can even see the Buddha. And you can even live forever with the Buddha. Entirely against the fundamental teaching of the Buddha, which is against egoism. But many things in the name of Buddhism have to be distorting the teaching of the Buddha. You have to understand that clearly.
So what do you think are the parameters? How can Buddhism survive and be whole and be okay in a capitalist society? Is it impossible?
Two things. The capitalist society, indeed, is coming to an end. People don't see it because they exploit each other too much, and they exploit natural resources too much. A lot of people realize that. Even people like Stiglitz, who received the Nobel Prize on Economics, said clearly that capitalism will not last, because if it lasts longer, the whole world will be destroyed. Climate change, big gap between rich and poor, more violence. So the Buddhists could help by studying the teaching of Buddha seriously and bringing to the modern world. 50 years ago, Schumacher, a German who became British, and a non-believer who became Catholic, but he was converted to Buddhist economic in Burma. He wrote that wonderful book, which became one of the bestsellers. It's a basic challenge to the mainstream economics. But we need to go deeper into that. I myself wrote a book called Wisdom of Sustainability, Buddhist economy for the 21st century, which has been translated to Japanese already. But we need to go beyond that. We are serious thinking, particularly among engaged Buddhists. We hope to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Buddhist economy in Burma. And we hope to bring top people, mainstream economists, as well as alternative, not only among Buddhists, even Christians like John Kopp, with Dali, who used to advise the World Bank. John Kopp and Dari wrote a book called The Common Good, Christian Economy. I think we should come together and produce perhaps one textbook alternative to the mainstream. I think most colleges would be welcoming that. I think that would be one answer, because the answer must be deeply educational. I think that may help. And if capitalism will survive, it will survive more meaningfully, less exploitative, and become teaching more contentedness, not competitive, or compete in a proper way, not in a negative way like they do now.